Welcome to you all in e-learning. Today we are going to learn about standard 9 subject Sanskrit and third chapter by the name Param Nidanam Kaho. What is the great praiser? Students, we have already seen the beginning of this lesson in the first part of video, right? In that we have seen that there is one king by the name Bhoj who is the lover of fine art, learning and devoted to all these subjects. Now, many people used to come in the assembly of King Bhoj from far off country to display their skills and talent. One day, King Bhoj was sitting in the balcony of his palace. At that time, he has seen one young one. He is passing from the way. Now, when King Bhoj has seen that person, he thinks that this person is unknown, unfamiliar. I must have introduction of this fellow. So he calls that person in the palace. Afterwards, that person comes and conversation took place between King Bhoj and that young man. So first of all, King Bhoj says that, "Who are you?" Then that young man says that, "I am Ghatpandit. This name is not it is not casual name." So that King Bhoj was thinking that Ghatpandit, what indeed does mean your name? Then Ghatpandit is explaining the meaning of his name. He says that as we can feel the preacher up to its brim, likewise I am having full of knowledge in myself. So I call myself Ghatpandit. After listening this proud speech of this young one, King Bhoj wants to emphasize or wants to show that he is more better than this person. He says that if you are a pot pitcher, then I am a hammer, and I can destroy you with my own stroke. So, Ghatpandit says further that if you are a hammer, then I will become fire. And as you know that the work of fire is to burn, and the one you are in a form of hammer, I will turn you, I will destroy you into ash. So up to here we have seen the lesson in the first part, and it is already linked in the description. Now let me start about second part, in which remaining lesson we are going to discuss. Here, Bhoj, when the young man says that if you are a hammer, then I will become fire, and as the work of fire is to burn, I will turn you into ash, I will destroy you like this. After listening the words of this young man, King Bhoj says that यदि त्वं वर्गित्वेन वर्तिष्यसे तर्हि अहं दृष्टि भवामि. Now यदि means if. Students, you may note down the words also. यदि means if. यदि त्वं, त्वं means you. यदि त्वं वर्धित्वेन means in a form of fire. In the form of if you are in the form of fire, tarhi means that, tarhi aham drushti bhavami. Pavishyami, tarhi means then. destroy you, I will turn you into ashes. After listening these words of young man, King Bodh says that if you will become the fire, if you are in the form of fire, then I will become rain. I shall be rain. Vrushte puratah varhi hastatam na saknoti. Vrushteha means rain. Puratah means in front of. Puratah means in front of. In front of. Sthatum na saknoti. Sthatum means to stand and na saknoti means cannot. Tatha. Tam tvam api. Tvam plus api. Mama puratah sthatum na sakno si. Tatha means and tvam api. You also. Mama puratah. In front of me. Sthatum. Sthatum means as we have seen to stand. Na sakno si. Cannot. So write down the words like sthatum means to stand. Means with By becoming big, I will blow you here and there with my own force. With my own force. Further he says that Vrushti Rupam, the one you are in the form of a rain, Bhavanta Maham. You are who is in the form of a rain, Vayu Bhutva, by becoming a fire, Itaha Tataha Vahishyami. Itaha Tataha means here and there, and Vahishyami. Vahishyami means I blow or I carry. Here and there, and Vahishyami. So, when King Bodh says that if you will become fire, then I will become rain, and by becoming rain, you will. If I will become rain, and by becoming rain, you are not able to stand in front of me, as fire cannot stand exist in front of rain. So likewise, I will be above to you. Then the young man says that if you will become rain, if you will become rain, then I will become, and then I will become wind, and by becoming wind, I will blow you here and there with my own force, and I will blow you here and there with my own force. So likewise, I will be above to you. See, as in front of fire, rain. If there, then fire cannot exist, right? Likewise, in front of rain, if wind is there, then wind can blow the force of rain in any direction according to its wish, right? If rain is falling and wind is there, then rain can blow here and there with the force of wind. So the young man wants to say that if you will become rain, then I will become wind, and by becoming wind, I will blow you here and there. Further, King Bodh says that yadi bhavana vatatvena vartishyate tarhi aham vayubhakshakam bhujagam bhavishyami. Yadi means if, bhavana means you, vatatvena in the form of wind. King Bodh is telling to the young man that if you are in the form of wind, if you are in the form of wind, tarhi aham vayu bhakshakam bhujaga bhavishyami. Tarhi means then, aham means I, vayu bhakshakam. Vayu means wind, and bhakshakam means the one who eats, right? Bhujagaha means snake. Bhavishyami, I shall be. So, Vayu bhakshakam. Or the one who consumes wind. Here, in this particular word, compound is there, Vayu Bhakshaka. It is in Shashti Tatpurusha compound, Vayu Bhakshaka. It is made out of two words, Vayu and Bhakshaka. Shashti Tatpurusha compound, Vayu Bhakshaka, Bhujagaha. Bhujagaha means snake. Satatam means constantly. constantly. Vayurupam. Vayurupam means in the form of wind. Bhavantam means to you. Bhakshayishyami. Bhakshayishyami means I shall eat.
Chakra dharaka in this particular word
there is a compound. It is made out of Shashti Tatpurush compound. Chakrasya Dharagah. Chakra Dharagah. If you are the eagle, King Bodh says that if you are the eagle, then I am Vishnu holding Sudarshan Chakra. Vishnu Garuda Rudha Bhavati. Now Vishnu Garuda Rudha. Garuda plus Arudha. Here two words are there. And here it is of Dritiya Tatpurush compound, Garudam Arudham. It is made out of two words, Garudam and Arudham. It is compound and it is a Dritiya Tatpurush compound. Vishnu Garuda Arudha Bhavati. Vishnu used to sit or rides on the eagle. See, King Bhoj is telling to the young man, when young man is telling that if you will become snake, then I will become eagle, and by becoming eagle I will constantly consume you, the one who is in the form of a snake. Then Bodh says that if you will become eagle, then I will become Lord Vishnu, the one who is holding Sudarshan Chakra. If you will become eagle, then I will become Lord Vishnu, the one who holds the Sudarshan Chakra, and by becoming Vishnu I will sit on Garuda, or I will ride on the Garuda. So likewise, I will above to you and you are below to me. And Vishnu rides on the eagle. Likewise, he wants to represent that I am better than you. Then Yuvak says, Manasha Vishnu Pranamya. Manasha means with my
मुकुटं सदा मस्तकस्य उपरि एव संतिष्ठते मुकुट
Here in this last line, he wants to say that young man is displaying his scholarship by showing or by going down Vishnu mentally, and further he says that